Welcome back, guys. Part two of our Canadian trip. Going on into Toronto, Ottawa to Toronto right now. Just came through transition altitude to Toronto. We've been cleared on down to 12,000 feet. We're to expect runway 33 right via the Rajid 2 arrival. So much smaller than 330 would have used to been flying for the past 6 months, 5-6 months.
Crew 31, turn heading 150. Right there and heading 150, Crew 31.
I was hoping he would vector us straight up.
Heading 455, continue descent 8,000. Crew 31, descend 4,000. Descend 4,000, Korean, wait 1 heavy. Crew 31, turn right heading 230. Right turn heading 230, crane 31.
Just make out the airport, yes, there it is. Just under 15 miles now to it. Which is nice because we're going to go right over downtown Toronto, it looks like.
Crane 31, turn right, heading 2700, the localizer cleared ILS, runway 33 right approach. Right turn 270, ground localizer, runway 33 right, will report established. Green, wait 1 heavy. Canada 455, descend 6,000.
Down to 6,000, or Canada 455.
We need more drag, sir. We need more drag, sir.
And Korean 281 is established.
We need more drag.
Korean 281, the Toronto winds are 350 at 16 minutes in Toronto 1, clear line runway 33 right. Clear line runway 33 right, Korean 281.
Bit of turbulence coming through there. Wow. Jesus. Yeah, that's kicking us all over the place. Wow. Holy moly. So super turbulence there.
Kind of 455, it's not 4,000.
Out of 4,000 for air.
We need more drag, sir. Spoilers full.
Why is it like fucking dive bombing? This plane, I'm telling you, it's so like wonked out.
Kind of 455, turn right, heading 230.
Right, 230 for K, 455. I'd be very happy landing in this weather right now.
Kind of 455, turn right heading 300, joins the local class of cleared islands, runway 33 right approach.
Right 2300.
Approach phase activated.
Clinton, welcome Toronto Taxi via Echo. Taxi via Echo for Green 21.
We're going to keep the speed to where established. Set our approach switch. Glide slope is captured. Flaps 1.
Speed checked. Flaps 1.
And gear down.
Gear down.
Kelly 455, Toronto Windsor 3506, gusting 21, clear to land runway 33 right.
Clear to land runway 33 right, Air Canada 445.
Speed checked, flaps 2. Radio altimeter alive.
Checked, flaps.
Spoilers armed.
Spoilers armed. Flaps going down to 3.
Speed checked, flaps 3. Speed checked. Flaps full.
It's windy. Wow. Gonna ride this in, guys. It's a little too windy to deal with this right now.
One thousand.
500.
Check. My
aircraft. No, I don't really. 400.
My aircraft. It's my aircraft.
Land green checked.
Hundred
above.
Minimum.
Landing.
Hundred. 50. 40. 30. 20. Retard. Retard.
Ground spoilers.
Ooh. That wind. Wow. That just chucked me into the ground. That was no joke. That was not good. Well, bad, but it was good. Some cuts.
70 knots.
Canada 455 is off runway 33 right on November.
Canada 455, welcome to Toronto. Continue straight ahead. Turn right on Bravo and then left on Alpha Juliet to the apron.
Right on to Bravo, left on to Alpha Juliet to the apron, Air Canada 455. Thanks for ATC, sir.
Roger.
Alright, strobe lights can go off. Weather system can go off. All right, guys, well, there you have it. That, my friends, was intense. We kind of got slammed into the ground there a little bit. I looked down for 2 seconds to make sure our speed was okay. And, this is Alpha Foxtrot. Alpha Juliet's going to be up here. Alpha Tango. But anyways, not that bad. A little bit harder landing than what we're used to. We're in the 300s there, so not the end of the world. It was it still acceptable. But yeah, that was pretty damn intense. That's for sure. So one thing that I noticed, the wind the whole time too, is it was it's not, I mean, there is gusts, but it's, if you look here, you'll see, like, the wind's actually, like, variable between, you know, like, 20, 30 degrees sometimes, so that's what was, I think, really throwing me off. Like, it just went to 3, 4, 8, and I don't think that's what it actually is. Give me 2 seconds, guys. I'll be right back.
Park brake on.
Sorry about that, guys. Had an unexpected guest.
Park brake off.
Let's get going. For him, so it doesn't look like we're just standing right there. Alright, Alpha Juliet. Here we are. So yeah, going on about the winds, yeah. So it's not, doesn't... This is 340, so... Maybe they are variable, who knows.
Flaps 3, flaps 2, flaps 0.
We did everything else. We didn't trim anything up. Actually gonna jump to this gate right here on the corner. I usually park here when I come into Toronto. Really hoping somebody does an updated scenery for Toronto. That would be amazing. I would appreciate that very much. Yeah, there you have it, guys, pulling up to the gate in Toronto, at gate 139, apparently. There you go, and let's look down here, park brake going on.
Park brake on.
There it is, engine mode selector over here, and we can shut down engine 1, engine 2, let's go up top, fuel pumps can go off, our ideas. Off. Off, off, off. Nose wheel light can go off, runway turnoffs can go off, wing lights can go off, a beacon can go off, and everything else is off. Seatbelt signs can go off. And let's go here. Let's go ahead and get our ground power. Let's get our catering. That can go off, and that can go off. Ground power is available. Disconnect the APU. APU going off. Bang, bang, bang. Let's get some lights going on in here. Alright. And there you have it, guys. The landing in Toronto. I hope you guys enjoyed the short little flight. This was for all my Canadian amigos. Let's open all the doors here for them. And, yeah. Catch you guys on the next flight. Cheers.
Toronto Center, good evening.